It's the EATEL Game of the Week. I'm Patrick Email, along with my spotty Robbie Dozier and Andre on the board and the cameraman Luke. We bring in you the Panthers and the Griffins for Week 6 District 5 5A action. We're looking forward to a tremendous contest as we get a view from the 50-yard line high above Woodlawn Stadium on December 8th, correction, October 8th, 2021. We'll be back.
New inventory arriving weekly at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. We've got truckloads of inventory en route. Even if you don't see it on the lot, it's on the way during the end of summer sale at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. Like the new 2021 Sierra 1500 on the way at RossDowningHammond.com. RossDowningGonzales.com.
Dr. Brian Hollis is Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Dr. Hollis has an excellent reputation for bringing state-of-the-art technology and the highest standard of patient care to Ascension. He attended LSU Dental School, and he completed a residency to become a board-certified specialist in orthodontics. An avid supporter in our community, Dr. Hollis is married to Celeste Pyra Hollis, and they have four children. Dr. Hollis, Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Grow up smiling with Hollis Orthodontics.
It's game day. A day that should be spent in the living room, not the kitchen. So next game, you just worry about the score, because we've got the food covered. With hand-battered, cooked-to-order, always fresh, never ever frozen chicken fingers, craveable cane sauce, crispy crinkle-cut fries, and jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers, one love.
The Tata Law Firm has been fighting for our clients to get their best recovery for over 20 years. And now that tradition will continue to the next generation.
Hi, I'm Rick Tata, the newest member of the Tata Law Firm.
We understand that it can be frustrating dealing with your claim.
So we're here to help you get what you deserve. If you're seriously injured in an accident, call the Tata Law Firm today.
We're not just a face on an ad.
Call 756-0007 when you're injured. You gotta call Tata.
We're back at the EATEL Game of the Week. Woodlawn Panthers have made their way to the sidelines. Captains for the Woodlawn Panthers tonight, number 25, Matthew Sant, senior. Number 58, Jerron Lewis. Number 13, Deshaun Flowers. And number 5, Armani Givens. The American flag and the colors make their way to midfield.
Good evening, football fans. The Woodlawn High administration, faculty, and coaching staff would like you to welcome you to Panther Stadium for tonight's district opener between the Woodlawn Panthers.
The national anthem will be played by the Woodlawn Panther Band.
Fans, at this time, please stand and remove your hats for the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you. very nice rendition of the national anthem. Coaches for tonight's contest from Woodlawn in his third year with a record of 5-14, Marcus Randall. And for Dutchtown, Guy Mastretta in his fifth season with a record of 30-16. 14th year in the profession, 146-60 overall with a couple state championships. Dutchtown versus Woodlawn, 7-2 Dutchtown edge. Unfortunately, I was part of that first Woodlawn victory, talking about it on my pregame show. And as soon as we kicked the ball off to a guy we wasn't supposed to kick it off to, he took it to the house. Benny Sayre fired me before he reached the end zone.
Captains for tonight's contest for Dutchtown, number 53, Will DeLong. Number 10, Tanner Vedness.
Captains for Dutchtown, number 53. Will DeLone, and number 10, Tanner Vadney, and number 21, Dylan Sampson. Really looking forward to an outstanding contest tonight to start District 5-5A, week six of the season. Dutchtown sitting at 4-0 currently with a win over Covington. And the first week we played, which was week two of the season after the hurricane, against Covington, slow start for the Griffins, led 7-0 at halftime on a pick six, and they roared back in the second half to finish off Covington. And then Evangel came to town with a young squad, make the long trek from Shreveport. Griffins took care of business there. Cy Academy the next week on homecoming for the Griffins. And last week, week five, took their first road trip of the season to Monroe and pulled out a 42-33 win against Washita. Woodlawn fell to Zachary last week to fall to 1-3. Their first win was their only win was a forfeit COVID win. And while playing the Monsters of the Midway with U High, top-ranked team in 4A, made a trek to West Monroe the following week and then falling to Zachary last week. Woodlawn won the toss. They elected to receive. Woodlawn will kick off. The highlighters, the headliners, I should say, for tonight's game, obviously Dylan Sampson with a commitment to the University of Tennessee in the SEC. Just today, Ricky Collins, the quarterback, the leader of the Panthers, committed to the Purdue Boilermakers. So a clash of the SEC and the Big Ten. Those are the headliners. We'll talk about the big guys up front, try to highlight some of those guys that make their job a little bit easier. Left footer number 96, Jacob Etter, to kick it off. Soon as the white hat lets us know we're ready for play. Number two, Clayton Adams, a junior wide receiver deep for the Panthers. Here's the whistle. And we're underway. Clayton drops it about the 10-yard line, picks it up about the 8-yard line, comes back. Alvin loses. Gets up, and they bring him down at the 11-yard line.
For the Panthers, tackled by number 11, Alvin Lewis. First and 10 from the 11-yard line.
Alvin missed him on the first drive, was able to get off the ground. That's what you tell Hustle. To be able to bring him down. We'll talk about the starters. Ricky Collins in the shotgun, offset by Armani Givens in the handoff. Starts up the middle, darts off right, tackle. Picks up about three. We'll call it second and seven from their own 15.
Second down, six.
Trips left, split right. A little flare outside of number two. Looks like he has a first down. Tackle by number 25, linebacker Dixon Agoo.
First down.
Clayton Adams on the reception. First down for the Panthers. Amani Givens around left end. Picks up about eight before he's brought down by Evan Reddix, number 26 for the Griffins.
Seven, second down, three.
We'll get to the starter as soon as we get a pause in the action. Dutchtown high in that traditional four-man front. Collin looked, number nine, wide open across the middle. Jalen Henry, their go-to wide receiver. Crosses midfield. Woodlawn going quickly. Chain set. Ball snap. Amani gets his third carry of the ball game. Breaking tackles. He gains 10. Brought down by Dixon Agoo and Evan Reddix.
Brings up second down and one.
Looks like it's less than one. Surprised they don't measure here. Collins drops back. Number two across the middle. He's open. He's caught.
Collins pass.
Brought down about the 16-yard line by A.K. Burrell. Junior free safety moving over from the offensive side of football. Just a post route. Amani Givens.
Givens on the carry.
Off left tackle.
By number two, Burrell.
Burrell brings him down about the 4.5-yard line.
First and goal, Panthers.
Panthers on a nice drive starting at their own 11-yard line. And Givens.
Givens on the carry.
Scores around left end. Not surprising, two seniors on the left-hand side for the Woodlawn Panthers on the O-line. So 9:33, Woodlawn is on the board. Extra point pending. Looks like number 45 for Woodlawn to attempt the extra point. Nope, not number 45. Either that or he is an inside linebacker as well, number 46. No 46 on the roster. Offside on Dutchdown. Would be half the distance to the goal. Coach Randall choosing to still kick the extra point instead of go for it. Sometimes coaches make the decision to go for it when they get half the distance.
The kick is up and good with 9 minutes and 33 seconds.
I think the snap was by number 60. The hold was by number six. Roy Brackens? Perhaps Roy Brackens. Yep, he's a shotgun center. Makes sense that he could snap on extra points. And the holder was Kyle Jones, wide receiver, normally with good hands. Number 82 to kick off for the Panthers. He's not on the roster. 9:33 left to go in the first quarter. Woodlawn strikes first. Baylor Langlois, number 7, takes it right up the middle. Breaks a few tackles, carrying a few defenders. Crosses the 40-yard line, brought down by a host of Panthers. Number 12 looked like he was the lead guy, or at least last to get off the pile. Kedrick Owens, an outside linebacker.
To the 41-yard line, Griffin take over first and 10.
Griffins start their first drive. They're on 41-yard line. Referee flag on the play. Just a warning, sideline warning perhaps. White Hat didn't give us a call. Pearson Pyro in the gun. Dylan Sampson to his right. Fake it to Dylan. Pearson Pyro takes it for 12. Brought down by Desiree Delmore, number 8 for the Panthers. Starters for the Griffins at quarterback. Pearson Pyro, running back Dylan Sampson. Baylor Langlois, wide receivers Leif Watkins, LeManuel Turnipseed, and the H-back Caleb Ickes. We'll get back to that momentarily for the big guys up front. Can't leave those guys out. Dylan Sampson carries behind the right side and the left side pulling. Chris Cooper on the carry. Correction, on the tackle. Gain of 14. And the guys up front, left tackle Will DeLone, left guard Ty Quibito. Grandmother cooks a mean hamburger, by the way. Hayden Harms, the center. Michael Jones, number 79 and number 77, Ethan Fields. Dylan motions, hand to Baylor Langlois. He has room off the right side. He is number 7. Number 7 brings down number 7, Jordan Matthews, who has some Big Ten offer, I think a Penn State offer.
Second down and 2.
Early indication this is going to be a high-scoring affair as Dutchtown picks up a couple first downs. They move from their 41-yard line. Currently, ball resting at Woodlawn's 28-yard line. Trip split. They hand to Sampson. Wide zone left side. He picked up a first down on about a 5-yard carry. Jaden Wood and Deshaun Flowers on the tackle, but it's a first down for Dutchtown. Chain moving, clock running, 7:43 left to go in the first quarter. Caleb Ickes, 88, returning from an injury. Good to see him back out there. Missed a couple weeks. New formation for Dutchtown right there. Caleb Ickes is playing a true tight end with Colin Landry, who filled in admirably for Ickes while he was out. Chris Cooper on the tackle for Woodlawn. Now the pickup of 6, long 6, short 7. Second down for Dutchtown. Both offensive lines getting the better of both defensive lines at the moment. Dutchtown too tight. Two flanker, pistol formation. The snap, handed to Dylan, deep. Dylan at the 4, steps out of bounds. After a pickup of 10 plus, run out of bounds by Desiree Delmore.
First and goal, Griffin.
6:38, first and goal. Ball resting at the Panther 4-yard line. Baylor Langlois, wide left. Leif Watkins, flank right. Dylan DeSherry. And along with Ickes, they hand it to Dylan Sampson. Breaks a couple tackles. And in the end zone, the Griffins are on the board. 6:32 left to go in the first quarter. Behind that left side with Ty Quibido at the left guard and Will DeLone, the left tackle, along with Ickes, the tight end, and DeSherry, the sniffer back.
Jacob Etter in the kick.
Jacob Etter to kick. Quarterback Pearson Pyro on the snap. There's the kick. Ball's up. And it's good. Hold by number 13, Stephen. Correction, Sean Winfield. Got it confused with him and his brother. 7-7. And we'll be back on the ETEL Game of the Week.
The athletic training staff of Dutchtown High School would like to thank Hollis Orthodontics, Tata Law Firm, Raising Cane's in Prairieville, Ross Downing, GMC, Baton Rouge Orthopedic Clinic Foundation for their support of our sports medicine program.
And we're back. I guess I got to move my microphone. We're back for the ETEL Game of the Week. It's 7-7. The Griffins and the Panthers, what a tremendous first half of the first quarter as Jacob Etter looks to kick off for the second time in the ball game. Little sky kick to about the 25-yard line. Running across field, number 12 on the return. Gets across the 30 to about the 31-yard line. Kedrick Owens on the return. Starting lineups for the Woodlawn up. Sorry, this is the Griffin defense. At defensive end, Gabe Maribel. Zion Tremont at one defensive tackle. Aiden Lewis at another defensive tackle. Defensive end, Trendon Williams. And Anson McCaffrey. Given.
Javion Haynes on the carry.
Linebacker Carter Danbury and
gain of 4 yards. Second down,
Dixon Agu. Cornerbacks Alvin Lewis and Evan Reddix, along with strong safety Tanner Badney and free safety A.K. Burrell. First down carry by number 21 for the Panthers. Ricky Collins on a post to number 9. And he was open. Intended for Desiree, correction, Jalen Henry, number 9. A little bit of a scouting report I was given. Ricky Collins really likes number 9. Obviously on that post route, that's the second time he's gone to him on that route in this contest. Big play in the ball game early on. 3rd and 7 for the Panthers, going empty. Seems like the first team that gets a stop gets an advantage right here. Collins looks to his right, throws a smash route. Number 2 just misses it. Intended for,
pass, intended for Adams,
Clayton Adams.
Brings up 4th down for the Panthers.
And then 4th down for the Panthers. They bring on a guy we didn't think we were going to see early on tonight, the punter for the Panthers. Number 25, Matthew Sant. Correction, he's the snapper. Number 13, looks like he's going back to punt, Deshaun Flowers.
Flowers in the punt.
Amani Givens was not in that series, but he looks healthy. Maybe they're just sharing the reps, the punt's away. A.K. Burrell, fair catch at the Griffin 34-yard line, where they will start their second possession. 5:25 left to go in the first quarter. 7-7, Griffins with their second possession.
Is that a cake and chicken sandwich meal from Zaxby's?
Maybe.
Wow. Is it as delicious as it looks?
Definitely.
Can I just have one tiny bite?
Maybe.
What if I do the laundry for
the first drive of the ball game? Woodlawn goes 89 yards with an Armani Gibbons touchdown run. And the Griffins go 59 yards for their touchdown drive with a Dylan Sampson run. Two backs in the backfield along with Pearson. Pyron, Baylor Langlois. Pyron hands to Sampson. He breaks one tackle 4 yards deep. He carries another guy for 4 yards.
Sampson on the carry.
We'll call it a long four, short five on the carry for Dylan Sampson.
Number 24,
second down.
Gain of five, second down five.
Caleb Cooper, number 20 wide for the Griffins. Has him down as a freshman on the roster. Nope, that's Woodlawn. Wrong number. That's Jordan Gloston, number 20. Nice play by the defensive line. Stack up Sampson for no gain. Starting defense for the Panthers. Defensive end Ellis McKinley. Devin Jones at the nose guard. Defensive tackle Mark Felder. Inside linebacker Jaden Woods along with Mason Watson and Kedrick Owens. We'll get back to that in a moment. Trip split, Pearson, Pyron checked with the Dutchtown staff. Woodlawn running a three-man front, a 3-4. They switch to the Wildcat, direct snap to Dylan Sampson for no gain on third and five. So Woodlawn returns the favor. Rest of the starting lineup for Woodlawn. Outside linebacker Deshaun Flowers. And in the secondary is Marcus Stewart, Jordan Matthews, the headliner at cornerback number seven. Number eight, DJ Delmore and DeJuan Harris in the secondary for the Panthers. Number eight drops deep. Pearson Pyron converted snap of the punter, one of the top snappers in the country. Back deep to punt. There's the snap. Rugby-style punt. Woodlawn lets it roll. Gets a great bounce. Ball dies about the 8.5-yard line.
Ball is down at the 9-yard line. The Panthers take over. First and 10.
Aiden Abbott downs the football.
Hey, football fans. Leave the Hail Marys for the game and go for the sure thing when it comes to satisfying your craving. When you pick up Raising Cane's for game day, all you have to worry about is the score, because we've got the food covered. Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
Panthers with that third possession. Thought we had a LSU sighting right there. I thought the official was going to mark in the wrong spot, but gets it right. 8-yard line. Ricky Collins called the signals. Some people may call that duo. Some may call that counter tray. Pull with the backside guard and tackle. Big number 76. 71 pulling to the left. Armani Gibbons gains 8 on there. Tackled by Dixon Agu. Kind of a bunch tight. Hand to Armani. He cuts back right. And two friends, former teammates, Tanner Vadney and Armani Gibbons. And Vadney runs him down. Not before Armani makes it to the 45-yard line. Armani Gibbons with a few college offers. Comes out the ball game sharing the reps with number 21 for Woodlawn, Javion Haynes, junior running back. Same formation flip right here, kind of a tight bunch to the left. Handoff up the middle. Trey, trap, cut back, 21. 45 yards to the house. The Panthers, Javion Haynes, puts the Panthers back on the board. Kind of a quick trap up the middle. Appreciate Scott Stevens bringing a beverage to EATEL Voice to fill in for Jeff Porsche tonight. Quick strike capability, Woodlawn.
Empty extra point for the Panthers.
The kick, no good. Will that be a key factor in this contest before it's all over? And we'll be back with the EATEL Game of the Week.
The athletic training staff of Dutchtown High School would like to thank Hollis Orthodontics, Tata Law Firm, Raising Cane's in Prairieville, Ross Downing, GMC, Baton Rouge Orthopedic Clinic Foundation for their support of our sports medicine program.
We're back after commercial break. Woodlawn up 13-7 with 2:06 to go in the first quarter. Woodlawn had the ball three times, scored on that first possession, took a break, went three and out on that second possession, and just went 45 yards. Javion Haynes to give the Panthers the lead. Dutchtown scored on the Dylan Sampson run. Right up the middle on the left side to tie the ball game. Dutchtown getting that third possession. Kickoff goes to Leif Watkins, number 82. Brought down by number four with a nice hit. Chris Cooper, sophomore inside linebacker for the Panthers. Dutchtown will start from their own 26-yard line. 2 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Hayden Harms at center for the Griffins. Been the starting center for 3 years. Been pretty good with the snap. Pretty important in the shotgun offense to be able to get that. Late substitution by Dutchtown.
Timeout.
Causes Dutchtown to call a timeout. Coach Mastretta.
Hey, Panther fans.
Hustling to the official. We'll be back with the EATEL Game of the Week after these few short messages.
Welcome back. We've missed you. We know it's been tough. Because rebuilding your business isn't for the faint of heart. Your business needs a jump start. And we're here to help. Introducing Surge, symmetrical speed fiber internet from EATEL Business. Revved up data speeds at 30% off, plus 3 months free. We're glad you're back, and we're here to make your business surge.
Panthers lead. Griffins with that third possession. Coming out of a timeout. Pyron flanked by Baylor Langwy. He keeps it on a pull by number 81. For Dutchtown, Colin Landry. Short gain. Second down and about eight. Clock's running 1:32 and counting. Dylan Sampson not in the ball game. Baylor Langwa with the handoff. Carry the couple.
Langwa on the carry.
Panthers, number 10 on the tackle.
Met by Jaden,
Jaden Woods. Bring down. A key third down with 1 minute left to go in the first quarter. Griffin's trying to answer. They answered the first touchdown. They need to answer the second one. I'm looking for Dylan Sampson on the sidelines. Don't see him in the game. Hand off to Langlois. Right up the middle. Kind of a quick trap. He's short, though. Probably about a yard. The Griffins are short. Decision time for Coach Mastretta.
Fourth down. That's down.
DeJuan Harris on the tackle. Need the down marker guy to help me out. Help the announcer out. They're going to let the quarter run out.
The end of the first quarter of play.
End of the first quarter. We'll see what Coach Mastretta decides to do when we're back on the EATEL Game of the Week.
Welcome back. We've missed you. We know it's been tough. Because rebuilding your business isn't for the faint of heart. Your business needs a jump start. And we're here to help. Introducing Surge, symmetrical speed fiber internet from EATEL Business. Revved up data speeds at 30% off, plus 3 months free. We're glad you're back, and we're here to make your business surge.
And KWATHome.com. We're back. That was the end of the first quarter. Panthers lead 13-7. We'll flip the field. It's fourth and short. Coach Mastretta had to break to make a decision on whether he was going to go for it or he was going to punt the ball away. And it looks like the punting team is on the way on the field. Looks like number 89 is snapping for Dutchtown. That's Grant Denicola. Pearson Pyron deep.
Delmore back deep for the Panthers. Pyron in the kick for Griffins.
Whitehead having a discussion with his two officials over there. You know, always a threat when you have your starting quarterback as your punter. Dutchtown leads this series 7-2. Woodlawn's first win came way back 2006, 2005, when Dutchtown went from 4A to 5A and within the district. Moved to the Baton Rouge district. Definitely some confusion on the sidelines. It's fourth down, but it's not fourth and five. It was fourth and about two at the break. So the White Hats are discussing it again. And they're moving the chains back again. Hey, there is no instant replay in high school. But as long as they get it right, that's the main thing. Fourth and one will definitely change your decision compared to fourth and five. Now, looks like we got to move the football. Because they got the down marker at the 36-yard line, but the ball's at the 34-yard line. Know what I think the referee? The referee need fall break like Ascension Parish this weekend. Give them a break. I actually think the chain's right now. looks to be right.
Hey, football fans, leave the Hail Marys for the game and go for the sure thing when it comes to satisfying your craving. When you pick up Raising Cane's for game day, all you have to worry about is the score.
Because Woodlawn decided to play music over the loudspeaker. Santa was up 23-0 over McKinley. Somewhere in Baton Rouge, East Ascension is playing Catholic High. That's the other two games in District 5-5A tonight. Being I'm from down in the river parishes, St. James and Lutcher are doing battle tonight. Rumor has it St. James got the dog statue and threw it in the river. Yeah. I'm an Army Navy guy, and we have stolen the goat before, but we never threw the goat in the Hudson. Fourth and one. Now we got it straight. There's the snap. Pearson Power on rugby punt. Gets it off. Number 8 for Woodlawn deep. Desiree Delhomme.
Ball is down at the 35-yard line where the Panthers will take over.
Panthers going on your dial from left to right.
Southern Oaks Athletic Club is the home of the Woodlawn High swim team and tennis team. With a wide variety of fitness equipment, a climate-controlled pool, and 9 tennis courts, Southern Oaks is
good job by Marcus Randall and his coaching staff, mixing up the pass and the run. Ricky Collins can throw it. He can make all the throws. Really doesn't want to run it, only if he has to. Saw some highlights where he has run it. Ball settled at the 25-yard line. Same formation, kind of the tight trips to the right side. They ran trap out of it last time for 45 yards touchdown last time they had the football. Armani Givens in the backfield.
There was a flag on the
Brody ball. Anderson start from the coming back from injury. He's in the ball game. Armani Givens giving the football, finds a hole off the left side. Gains about 10. Brought down by Alvin Lewis.
Second down, one.
Second and one for the Panthers. Same formation. Trap. Weaving and finding a hole. Still going. Picks up about 8 for the Panthers.
That's enough for a Woodlawn Panther. First down.
Woodlawn has pretty good size up front on that offensive line, taking advantage of it. Ricky drops the football. I told you he could run. Nice tackle by number 26, Evan Reddix, for the Griffins.
Evan Reddix.
Short gain, second and about 8. I think Ricky got a little anxious, took his eyes off the football right there.
Seven.
Ricky rolls out. Trenton Williams contains. Nice play right there.
Intended for Henry, falls incomplete.
Intended for, I think, number 8 for Woodlawn. Nope, sorry, number 9, Jalen Henry, on account of a little delay. He was blocking on Trenton Williams, and then when Trenton released, Henry released. Quick throw by Ricky. Big play right here. Third and about seven or eight. 10:47 left to go in the first half. Number 21 in the ball game. Haynes at running back. Ricky didn't see him. Number 6, wide open. Didn't see him.
Number 25, Agu.
Dixon Agu brings him down. Going to be fourth and about five. Fourth and about four. Marcus Randall chooses to punt. Trying not to give Dutchtown High good field position.
Flowers in the kick for the Panthers.
Flowers, A.K. Burrell back deep. Sits about 37 yards, waiting for the delivery. Big bounce, catches it on one bounce. A.K. Burrell played running back last year, breaks a couple tackles. Return of about 7 yards, brought down by number 43 for the Panthers.
Where the Griffins take over first and 10.
Rasheed Williams.
Hey, Panther fans, Jay Ducote here from Food Network star Beat Bobby Flay and the Jay Ducote Show every Monday.
Dutchtown's got to find something they found on the first drive. Haven't been able to find on the last two drives.
Also, the founding father of Government Taco on Government Street. Come try our tacos every day.
Dylan Sampson back in the ball game.
Jay Ducote, proud supporter of Woodlawn.
Trip split, Leif Watkins, number two, Baylor Langwa. And Caleb Ickey's in the three. Counter Trey. Pearson Pyron takes it behind Ty Quibido and Will DeLone pulling. Blocked down by. Blocked down by Ethan Fields. Brought down by Ketrick Owens. Same formation for the Griffins. Emmanuel Turnipseed up top as the lone receiver. Try to get him a jump. First and 10. Woodlawn Panther band trying to encourage the Panther defense. Same play. Pyron patient.
Pyron on the keeper. No gain on the play.
Stop for a 2 yard loss. Looks like Evan Miller on the stop for the Panthers. Second and about 12, 8:53, clock moving. In the first half, 13-7, Panthers hold an edge. Pyron yet to put it up in the air. Caleb Langwa, right side, a flag on the play. Gained about 10.
Flag on the play.
Goes out of bounds.
Holding against the Griffins.
Holding on the Griffins. Going to make it second and 22 for the Griffins. Nice little play right there. Send Sampson in motion. He's going to get a lot of attention. Send Baylor Langwa down to the right side. Baylor Langwa got some college offers. So when you hand him the football, a lot of good things happen when you're running behind big Ethan Fields, Mike Jones, Hayden Harm, Ty Quibido, and Will DeLone. Little screen play. Baylor Langwatt sniffed out. Made the first guy miss. Picked up about two. Maybe three. Bring up third and long for the Griffins.
Gain of 2 yards. Brings up third down and long.
Santama leads 45-6 against McKinley. 5:29 left to go in the third quarter. Clock moving in that contest. Sprint draw, give it to Sampson. Doesn't fool Woodlawn. Gain of about six. Going to bring up third and 16, brought down by Ketrick Owens.
Number 12, Ketrick Owens.
For Woodlawn. Dutchtown's going to punt for the third time in the contest. Clock moving, 7:10. left to go in the half.
Adams back deep for the Panthers.
Dutchtown calls timeout.
Timeout, Dutchtown.
Woodlawn comes into this game 1-3.
Operated, Mason's Grill is famous for our burgers and our weekend brunch. Kids eat free every
You can't
Monday
always go by the record, though. Their one win was a COVID forfeit victory. And losses to U-High, number one team in 4A.
Staff 7 days a week, and follow us on Facebook and Instagram for all of our special
34-14. That game was a lot closer than that. Whenever you get a forfeit win, 2-0 is the score. West Monroe 27-0. That game was 14-0 at halftime. First time Woodlawn had made that trip up there this season, obviously a long trip. And Zachary, 35-28. Woodlawn down early in that game, was able to make it a contest, where Zachary had to go for it on fourth down in order to preserve a victory. Faked a punt to keep Ricky Collins and the Panthers from having another shot with the football. Snap, pressure by number 10 for Woodlawn. Nice punt. Jaden Woods with the pressure. There's a flag on the play. Nice tackle by number 8. Tyler Adams, sophomore wide receiver for the Griffins. Let's see what the penalty is. My spotter says personal foul. So that'll back him up. That'll be half the distance to the goal if that's the case. Ball marked down at the 20-yard line. That'll put it first and 10 at the 10-yard line for the Panthers. Personal foul, block in the back.
Block in the back against the Panthers is the call.
Make it about the 10.5-yard line.
Moves the ball back to the 11-yard line. First
make it first
10.
And 10 at the 11.
Woodlawn.
I think this is their second possession that starts at the 11. Ricky Collins taking all the snaps. Twins left, slot right. Back offset left, hand to number 21. Coming around right in. 25 and 26, Agu and Reddix on the stop.
Haynes on the carry.
After a gain of about 6.
Tackle by number 26, Reddix. Gain of about 5 yards. Second down, 5.
Haynes on that carry, number 21. Same formation. Little bit different. For the number 2 receiver, Collins finds number 6. On about a 5-in post right there, number 6, Kyle Jones. First down, nice throw. Here's the replay. Oh, it was a little slant and go, a little cross and go. Evan Reddix on the tackle. First and 10, little 5-yard in route, and then take it to the post. Nice route. Swing pass to number 2. Number 2. On the tackle, Clayton Adams brought down by A.K. Burrell. Nice 5-yard gain on first down.
Brings up second down for the Panthers.
Second and 5, 5-10 left to go. Trap up the middle, number 21 Haynes on his touchdown run. Same play, stop on the inside of Goo. And Aiden Lewis. Number 98 for the Griffins on the stop. Third and short, third and about 3.
Number 98, Aiden Lewis.
Aiden Lewis and Brody Anderson come off the field. Quick hitch to number 19. Number 19 on the reception. Jonathan Benton makes number 5. Caden Mackey miss, which would have been a first down, brought down by A.K. Burrell at the 30-yard line. 4:28, clock moving. Panthers trying to get one more score before halftime. Quick contest. Not too many balls hit the ground. Not too many penalties. Well, speak of, there's one right there. Stop the clock. Fast moving. Game started at 7 o'clock. Be halftime before 8 o'clock.
Against the Panthers is the call. That'll move the ball back 5 yards. First down.
Make it first and 15. Coach Randall got a haircut like mine, pulling his hair out when a wide receiver jumps. Big guys up front for Woodlawn doing a tremendous job. Jerron Lewis, 21 for the Panthers, with a nice 10-yard gallop James up the middle.
Takes the ball down to the 27-yard line.
And Haynes on the carry.
Second down and 7.
Cody Walker, Roy Bracken, Alonzo Taplin, and Tillon Day doing a great job for Woodlawn. Hit in the backfield by Trendon Williams for no gain.
Met by number 40, Hanson McCaffrey.
Hanson McCaffrey also on the tackle.
Third down for the Panthers.
Third down and 7, probably 4 down territory for the Panthers. Panthers go empty. Trips left. Twins right. Seven seconds left to go on the play clock. 2-1, get the ball off. Call timeout. Wasn't sure if he was going to get it away.
Timeout. Woodlawn.
Probably a good call by Coach
Woodlawn High.
Marcus Randall.
Brings martial arts.
Big play right here.
Community at Gracie United, South Baton Rouge. Located on the corner of Tiger Bend and Jones Creek, Tefu offers classes Monday through Friday for all skill levels.
Hey, Panther fans.
Dutchtown's got to figure out whether or not Woodlawn thinks they're in 4-down territory so they can make a decision. Upcoming game next week in District 5-5A, East Ascension at Dutchtown will be EA's homecoming. So it's at Dutchtown, but it's East Ascension's home game. Then Woodlawn versus Sanama at Dutchtown. That's a Thursday night game. And then McKinley at Catholic High in Baton Rouge. Not sure where they play. Change formations. Look like Amani Gibbons is a little bit wider here. He'll see whether he just runs the swing route right here. There it is. Nice throw. Dutchtown recognizes it. Ball comes out. Ball goes out of bounds. That's a nice play by the Dutchtown defense. Reckon that. Tanner Vadney brings down Armani Givens.
Brings up fourth down for the
fourth and about long 4.5, short 5. 2:29. I'm sure Coach Mastretta wish he had those 2 timeouts back. If we get a stop right here. No rush. Let the clock run if you're Woodlawn. If you make it, you still got plenty of time. 2 timeouts. Quick slant, quick hitch. First down. Number 2 on the reception. Clock stops on first down.
First down.
Caught a Hanberry on the tackle. 2:24. Clock winds. Dutchtown trying to make substitutions. Armani Givens around right in. Alvin Lewis.
Givens on the carry.
And Carter Hanberry.
Number 40.
Anson McCaffrey, sorry. on the tackle. After a 5-yard gain, 2 minutes left to go in the first half.
Down and five.
Hand it to Givens again. Behind big number 73, weaving his way. Dutchtown makes contact at the 6.5-yard line. Brings him down. Last guy off the pile.
The ball down to
number 39 looks like Trendon Williams. Shout out to Luke, our cameraman.
First down.
Andre on the board, producing this operation for ETEL. And Robbie Dozier, my spotter. Haynes back in the backfield, number 21, along with Ricky Collins. There it is. 73 pulling down right side. Great job by A.K. Burrell, dragging him down. It was first and goal at the 6. Now it's going to be second and goal from about the 4-yard line. Clock running.
2 yards, second down and goal.
1:10 left to go. Scoreboard says 3 timeouts apiece, but that's incorrect. Woodlawn, I think, has 2 timeouts left, maybe 1. Definitely 1 for sure. So they're in no rush. They're going to try to score on the last play here. 9 seconds left to go on the play clock. Motion. Woodlawn rolls out. Hits number 9. There's their go-to receiver. Number 9 for Woodlawn.
Touchdown, Panthers.
Jalen Henry. Put the Panthers up 19-7. 42 seconds left to go in the half. And Dutchtown is not going to, Woodlawn is not going to chase that extra point that they missed. They're going to go ahead and kick it right here to make it, try to make it 20-7. Number 8 on the hole for Woodlawn, Desiree Delmore. There's the snap by number 25. Matthew Sant for Woodlawn. The kick is good. 20-7. Under a minute left to go in the first half. And we'll be back with the ETEL Game of the Week.
Introducing outage text alerts from ETEL. Sign up is quick, free, and easy. Stay informed, receive updates, and get emergency messages. Plus, our outage text alerts will notify you when there is a service disruption in your area. Sign up in 3 easy steps. Just log into your account, go to Account Settings, and select Text Notifications. It's that simple. So, sign up today at myaccount.etel.com.
Forty-two seconds left to go in the first half. We're back on the ETEL Game of the Week. Woodlawn to kick off. After scoring on a Collins to Henry, 4-yard touchdown pass, sky kick. Aiden Abbott catches it.
Aiden Abbott on the return for the Griffin. Tackled by number 23, Bryce Collins.
40 seconds.
Ball spotted at the 35-yard line.
A couple of scoring updates for you. Evidently, Lutcher didn't take too kindly to the dog missing from the dog pound. They're up 28-0 over St. James. St. Charles leading 8-0 over Lakeshore. Bell Chase now up 9-7 over Riverside. And we gave you that Sentinel score earlier. 52 for the Gators current time. Quick hitch to Leif Watkins. Clock runs. Short gain of about 3 yards. Brought down by number 3, DeJuan Harris for Woodlawn. Clock running. Pyron rolls out, sees Ickes. Nice catch. Ickes gets out of bounds. Run out of bounds by number 6 and number 3. I think Kyle Jones and DeJuan Harris run him out of bounds. 14 seconds left.
First and 10.
42-yard line. Oh. Pyron was hit as he threw it. Intercepted. That'll end the first half.
Well, pass is intercepted. Desiree Delmore, and that is the end of the first
number
half.
Number 8, Desiree Delmore.
Woodlawn 20, Dutchtown 7.
At the half, 20-7, Woodlawn leads the Griffins. And we'll be back on the EATEL Game of the Week.
It's game day. A day that should be spent in the living room, not the kitchen. So next game, you just worry about the score, because we've got the food covered. With hand-battered, cooked-to-order, always fresh, never ever frozen chicken fingers, craveable cane sauce, crispy crinkle-cut fries, and jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers, one love.
New inventory arriving weekly at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. We've got truckloads of inventory en route. Even if you don't see it on the lot, it's on the way during the end of summer sale at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. Like the new 2021 Sierra 1500 on the way at RossDowningHammond.com. RossDowningGonzales.com.
You care about your car. So do we. Donaldsonville Glass and Body has been around for over 40 years, providing unparalleled collision repairs and customer service, especially when you and your car are having the worst day ever. When you demand exceptional workmanship, call Donaldsonville Glass and Body. Free pickup for your collision repairs and get it back as good as new. It's your choice, so why not choose the best? Donaldsonville Glass and Body.
Dr. Brian Hollis is Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Dr. Hollis has an excellent reputation for bringing state-of-the-art technology and the highest standard of patient care to Ascension. He attended LSU, LSU Dental School, and he completed a residency to become a board-certified specialist in orthodontics. An avid supporter in our community, Dr. Hollis is married to Celeste Pyron Hollis, and they have four children. Dr. Hollis, Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Grow up smiling with Hollis Orthodontics.
Piku Builder Supply, your one-stop lumberyard, provides an extensive selection of quality building supplies for your new construction and remodeling. We offer computer-aided estimating of your building and remodeling plans, as well as blueprint copies. From humble beginnings to becoming the industry leader in Gonzales and beyond, Piku proudly supports our local community because we believe in giving back to those who have had a hand in our success. Let the experts at Piku Builder Supply help you with your new project today.
If you believe in me, I'd be the first one in our family to graduate college.
I'll be the one to change our history of diabetes.
I'll live a healthy life.
If you believe in me, I'll know my worth is more than face value.
I'll be stronger than a weak heart.
I'll know 68 pounds carries weight in this world.
If you believe in me,
I'll believe in myself.
Belief in our children can change their future. Our Lady of the Lake Children's Health.
The Tata Law Firm has been fighting for our clients to get their best recovery for over 20 years. And now that tradition will continue to the next generation.
Hi, I'm Rick Tata, the newest member of the Tata Law Firm.
We understand that it can be frustrating dealing with your claim.
So we're here to help you get what you deserve. If you're seriously injured in an accident, call the Tata Law Firm today.
We're not just a face on an ad.
Call 756-0007 when you're injured. You gotta call. You gotta call Tata.
We're back at halftime. 20-7, the Panthers lead the Griffins. And if the Griffins don't want the Panthers to make that series 7-3, they're going to have a great second half. here at halftime. It's not the homecoming game, but the homecoming court for Woodlawn will be recognized, as the game was 2 weeks ago, a couple weeks ago, and it was a forfeit game. So they are honoring the court tonight for homecoming.
Rita Abuakar. She's being escorted by a family friend.
Woodlawn.
Rita participates in the Talented Theater and in the I Care Club. Her future plans are to pursue a career in clinical psychology and attend UCLA while joining the National Guard Air Force. Junior maid Rita Abuakar. Next is junior maid Layla Shelton. Layla participates in soccer and cheerleading. She plans to attend LSU after high school to study medicine. She likes to paint and run in her free time and spend time with her family and friends. Junior maid Layla Shelton. Next is senior maid, Carolina Alvarado Medell. She is being escorted by Coach Spruill. Carolina participates in cross country, soccer, track, and is on the Student Advisory Council. She plans to attend LSU to go into PA. She likes to run and spend time with her family and friends. Senior maid Carolina Alvarado Medell. Next is senior maid Jada Braxton. Jada is being escorted by her father, Jeffrey Braxton. Jada is a member of the Pantherettes dance team, a member of Lost in Sound, a DECA member on the Talent Music and Advisory Choir. She's a member of Great Scholars and on the tennis team. She plans to ascend Southern University seeking a degree in political science. She wants to pursue a career in law. She enjoys singing and dancing and Girl Scouts. Senior maid, Jada Braxton. Next is senior maid, Charlize Garcia Blanco. She is being escorted by her parents, Marisa Cruz and Alex Cruz. Charlize is a member of the yearbook staff on the soccer team and the DECA club. She would like to study business and management at LSU. She enjoys working at Chick-fil-A and playing soccer. Senior maid, Charlize Garcia Blanco. Is senior maid Isabella Chamber. She is being escorted by Joel Chamber. She participates in volleyball, powerlifting. She is the president of the Beta Club, the Girls Magnet STEM Club, the Self-Defense Club. She's a magnet ambassador, a member of Lost in Sound, and on the Advanced Choir. She also does our morning announcement and is a member of the Eye Care Club. she would like to study broadcast journalism and minor in linguistics. Senior Isabella Gamber. Our next senior maid is Haley Woods. Haley is a member of the Beta Club, Rebecca Club, participates in track and cross country. She plans on attending LSU to become a veterinarian. She enjoys volunteering at the animal shelter. Senior maid, Haley Woods. With King Larry Chase, we present the 2021 All right, here we go. Our 2021 homecoming queen, Miss Haley Woods. Congratulations to all our members of the 2021 Homecoming Court.
It's game day. A day that should be spent in the living room, not the kitchen. So next game, you just worry about the score, because we've got the food covered. With hand-battered, cooked-to-order, always fresh, never ever frozen chicken fingers, craveable cane sauce, crispy crinkle-cut fries, and jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
New inventory arriving weekly at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. We've got truckloads of inventory en route. Even if you don't see it on the lot, it's on the way during the end of summer sale at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. Like the new 2021 Sierra 1500 on the way at rossdowninghammond.com. rossdowninggonzales.com.
You care about your car. So do we. Donaldsonville Glass and Body has been around for over 40 years, providing unparalleled collision repairs and customer service, especially when you and your car are having the worst day ever. When you demand exceptional workmanship, call Donaldsonville Glass and Body. Free pickup for your collision repairs and get it back as good as new. It's your choice, so why not choose the best? Donaldsonville Glass and Body.
Dr. Brian Hollis is Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Dr. Hollis has an excellent reputation for bringing state-of-the-art technology and the highest standard of patient care to Ascension. He attended LSU, LSU Dental School, and he completed a residency to become a board-certified specialist in orthodontics. An avid supporter in our community, Dr. Hollis is married to Celeste Pyra Hollis, and they have four children. Dr. Hollis, Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Grow up smiling with Hollis Orthodontics.
PQ Builder Supply, your one-stop lumberyard, provides an extensive selection of quality building supplies for your new construction and remodeling. We offer computer-aided estimating of your building and remodeling plans, as well as blueprint copies. From humble beginnings to becoming the industry leader in Gonzales and beyond, PQ proudly supports our local community because we believe in giving back to those who have had a hand in our success. Let the experts at PQ Builder Supply help you with your new project today.
If you believe in me,
I'll be the first one in our family to graduate college.
I'll be the one to change our history of diabetes.
I'll live a healthy life.
If you believe in me, I'll know my worth is more than face value.
I'll be stronger than a weak heart.
I'll know 68 pounds carried weight in this world.
If you believe in me,
I'll believe in myself.
Belief in our children can change their future. Our Lady of the Lake Children's Health.
The Tata Law Firm has been fighting for our clients to get their best recovery for over 20 years. And now that tradition will continue to the next generation.
Hi, I'm Rick Tata, the newest member of the Tata Law Firm.
We understand that it can be frustrating dealing with your claim.
So we're here to help you get what you deserve. If you're seriously injured in an accident, call the Tata Law Firm today.
We're not just a face on an ad.
Call 756-0007 when you're injured. You gotta call. You gotta call Tata.
We're back at halftime of the EATEL game of the week, where Woodlawn leads 20-7 after a late score with under a minute left to go in the first half to put the Panthers up 20-7. At halftime, while it's homecoming recognition for the Panthers, we'll have the name of the king and the queen. We want to recognize Dylan Sampson of the Dutchtown Griffins. Last week, Dylan Sampson made school history twice during last week's game against Washita up in Monroe, including a second quarter run that left him as the all-time career rushing leader at the Geismar School. Halfway through his senior season, Sampson has eclipsed 4,298 yards on only 385 carries during his career as a Griffin, which started as a freshman going for over 100 yards against Catholic in his first game. Former NFL and Alabama standout Eddie Lacy had previously held the rushing record. Lacy played for the Griffins from 2006 to 2008, coming over after the Hurricane Katrina. Sampson's 287 rushing yards last week against Washita also set a school record for most rushing yards in a single game, eclipsing the mark previously held by Efren Reed with 268. Efren currently coaching for Michigan State up in the north. Sampson had rushed for 745 yards and 12 touchdowns entering tonight's contest. Coach Guy Mastretta said the dynamic running back, the fact that Dylan has passed Eddie Lacy as the program's career rushing leader, is a testament to his God-given ability and tremendous work ethic. Dylan is a dynamic back, but he'll be the first to tell you his offensive line did an outstanding job opening up holes for him. Quote from Guy Mastretta. Also a tweet from Eddie Lacy congratulating Dylan Sampson for the breaking his rushing record. Nice work, young king. Records are meant to be broken. Nice to hear Eddie Lacy say that. I had the privilege of coaching Eddie Lacy in 2006 and 2007. There is Dylan Sampson, the king. His teammates love him to death. They love blocking for him. It's easy when you know you're one of your best football players is one of your hardest workers. You know, Eddie Lacy, tremendously talented, spoke about him in the pregame show that he and Kelvin York were a tremendous duo in the backfield. Eddie was also a tremendous receiver with great hands. You know, he showed up on campus as a freshman or a sophomore, running 4.5 in high top sneakers and bench pressing 275, just tremendous talent. But Dylan Sampson came on the scene. We tried to hide him as a freshman, but a kid with that much talent, that much character, is kind of hard to hide him. And it's an honor to have watched him break the scoring record. You know, I'm going to sit here and say I can't wait till the next guy breaks Dylan, because it's been an honor. I just can't believe the tremendous long runs and tackles that a kid that weighs about 185, 195 pounds, committed to Tennessee, breaks, and just an honor and privilege to watch him run. So if somebody comes along, as long as I'm alive, that can break Dylan Sampson's all-time rushing record, if I'm not watching, somebody's going to watch an unbelievable talent. And we wish Dylan the best the rest of the season, and obviously on the way to Tennessee. And we'll be back for the second half for the EATEL Game of the Week.
New inventory arriving weekly at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. We've got truckloads of inventory en route. Even if you don't see it on the lot, it's on the way during the end of summer sale at Ross Downing Buick GMC Hammond and Ross Downing Buick GMC of Gonzales. Like the new 2021 Sierra 1500 on the way at RossDowningHammond.com. RossDowningGonzales.com.
Dr. Brian Hollis is Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Dr. Hollis has an excellent reputation for bringing state-of-the-art technology and the highest standard of patient care to Ascension. He attended LSU, LSU Dental School, and he completed a residency to become a board-certified specialist in orthodontics. An avid supporter in our community, Dr. Hollis is married to Celeste Pyra Hollis, and they have four children. Dr. Hollis, Ascension Parish's orthodontist. Grow up smiling with Hollis Orthodontics.
It's game day. A day that should be spent in the living room, not the kitchen. So next game, you just worry about the score, because we've got the food covered. With hand-battered, cooked-to-order, always fresh, never ever frozen chicken fingers, craveable cane sauce, crispy crinkle-cut fries, and jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
The Tata Law Firm has been fighting for our clients to get their best recovery for over 20 years. And now that tradition will continue to the next generation.
Hi, I'm Rick Tata, the newest member of the Tata Law Firm.
We understand that it can be frustrating dealing with your claim.
So we're here to help you get what you deserve. If you're seriously injured in an accident, call the Tata Law Firm today.
We're not just a face on an ad.
Call 756-0007 when you're injured. You gotta call. You gotta call Tata.
We're back on the campus of Woodlawn High School on Jefferson Highway, just across the Ascension Parish line, where the Panthers lead Alwa Griffins 20-7. It was homecoming recognition night for the Panthers. Congratulations to King Larry Chase and Queen Haley Woods. Shout out to my spotter, Robbie Dozier, Luke the cameraman, and Andre, who's giving me a 7.5 on the game tonight. So he, myself, and the Griffins need a better second half if the Griffins are going to lead the series 8-2 when this contest is over. Dutchtown made it to the sideline. They will receive the second half kickoff as the Panthers make their way to the sidelines. I understand Scott Stevens, principal of Woodlawn, is requesting a new press box here at Woodlawn Stadium. They're going to try to flip the process and put the home team on the west side and put the visitors on the east side. We'll see if that comes to fruition in the near future. Marcus Randall has done a great job in the first half of mixing up the run and the pass. Ricky Collins, the headliner, but he only has one touchdown pass, but has several nice throws deep across the middle to his wide receiver. His one touchdown to number 9, Jalen Henry, with touchdown by number 21, Henry, and number 5, Armani Givens. Dutchtown lone score coming from number 21, Dylan Sampson. Nice recognition to him at halftime. Been a pleasure to watch him over the last 4 years. You always wish good things for good people, and Dylan Sampson is a quality kid. And just turning 17 years old, I can tell you, in my honest opinion, that Tennessee has got a good one. You put 20 pounds on Dylan, who weighs about 185 or 190, who runs like he's 210, you put 20 pounds on him and get him near 210, he's going to run like he's 230. And the Tigers better hope they don't play that guy and get the rock to him in the next 4 years. But Ricky Collins committed to Purdue today, and he's having a tremendous impact leading his crew. The headliner on the Woodlawn Panther defense is Jordan Matthews with, I think, a Penn State offer, if memory serves me correctly. Here's the kick to start the second half. It's a pooch kick, and it goes out of bounds to start the second half. Great field position for Dutchtown.
The kick sails out of bounds.
Big momentum drive to start the second half. Dutchtown needs to answer. They need some confidence. Woodlawn's in a strange position. They're a leading 20-7 after trailing and losing to U-High, West Monroe, and Zachary last week.
Ball will be spotted at the 35-yard line. First and 10, Dutchtown.
Guys up front for Dutchtown. Left tackle, Will DeLone. Left guard, Ty Quibido. Hayden Harms at center. The right guard, can't see his number. Looks to be 62, perhaps. 62. Hunter Lowry. And Ethan Fields, the right tackle. Pyron calls for the snap. Puts it in the belly of Dylan Sampson. Keeps it. Gains about 7.
All right, on the carry,
number 23, Bryce Collins, free safety.
Bryce Collins on the tackle.
On the tackle.
Gain of 6 yards. Second down, 4.
Baylor Langwa in motion. Snap, Holland, Taylor Ickes, and Dylan Sampson breaks into free. Puts it in fifth gear, and he scores.
Sampson on the carry.
60-plus yards. Dylan Sampson with the first score of the second half. Hands the ball to the referee and brings the Griffins within 8 with the, correction, within 7 with the extra point coming. 11-13, just what the doctor ordered for the announcer, who was a 7.5 in the first half. And Dylan answers to make the Griffins
20-13.
Sean Whittenfield to hold. Jacob Eater, left footer. Ball's up. Looks like it's good.
It's up and good. And, with 11,
and before you can get settled in your seat on homecoming, it's 20-14. And we'll be back for the ETEL Game of the Week.
The athletic training staff of Dutchtown High School would like to thank Hollis Orthodontics, Tata Law Firm, Raising Cane's in Prairieville, Ross Downing, GMC, Baton Rouge Orthopedic Clinic Foundation for their support of our sports medicine program.
Just like that, 47 seconds into the second half, The Griffins are on the board. They make it a one-score game, 20-14, as the Griffins are about to kick off. Number two for the Panthers. Adams and number 21, Haynes, deep for the Etter kick, sky kick. Taken by Adams about the 20-yard line.
Adams on the carry.
Last Griffin off the pile is number 10, Tanner Vadney, on the tackle. Woodlawn field position, 35-yard line. Big guys up front, Tillon Day at right tackle, Alonzo Taplin at right guard, Roy Brackens at center. Cody Walker, left guard. And Ricky Collins hands it to Armani Gibbons around left end. Stiff arm. Runned out of bounds. After about a 7-yard gain, Evan Reddix runs him out of bounds.
Out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Running behind number 58, the big left tackle, Jerron Lewis.
Second down, one.
Senior offensive tackles for Woodlawn. Woodlawn's been running this little tight bunch formation and running trap out of it. Nope, just inside zone. Armani Gibbons.
Gibbons on the carry.
Not much hold, but yet gains 5 yards for a first down.
That's enough for a Woodlawn Panther.
Dixon Agu on the tackle. Along with Aiden Lewis. Twin slot, Ricky Collins with Gibbons offset left. Quick trap, up the middle, Armani Gibbons.
Armani Gibbons on the
goes 16 yards
down
on a quick hitter. Brought
line.
Down by Tanner Vadney.
Panther, first down.
Just a little quick trap. Shortest distance between 2 points and the goal line is a straight line, and a little geometry algebra reference. Haynes, tackle. Good job by the defensive line. First to make contact, Trendon Williams, number 39 for the Griffins.
Met by number Haynes stop. Will DeLong. No gain on the play. Second down, 10.
Along with Will DeLong, seeing action on both sides of the football. Look for number 9 right here. The number 2 receiver in the trips, Henry. Oh, screen pass. Collins tucks it. Chased out of bounds.
Collins on the keeper.
Carter Hanbury, number 22,
yard line.
For a short gain. Woodlawn tries to set up a screen on the play. Dutchtown does a good job of sniffing it out. Third and 9. Huge play in the ball game. I know I keep saying that. Not trying to be repetitive. Illegal flag procedure. Make it 3rd and 14 for the Panthers.
The Panthers is the call. Moves the ball back 5 yards. Takes up 3rd down and 14.
If you believe in Santa Claus, the Easter Bunny, and the Tooth Fairy, maybe you believe in big momentum on your side, because Dutchtown's trying to grab it right here. It's a sack. It's a strip. A blitz by Tanner Vadney. 71, Tillon Day falls on it. A huge play for the Griffins. to get the defensive off the field.
Number 71, Day on the recovery.
Tanner Vadney has been a turnover machine for the Griffins throughout his career. Several pick sixes, couple interceptions this year.
Flowers in the front for the Panthers. Burrell back deep for the Griffins.
A.K. Burrell back deep. Clock running, 5-4. Short personnel, going to be a delay of game on Woodlawn. Back him up 5 yards. And I need a calculator on fourth down to tell you where the first down marker. If it tells you anything, A.K. Burrell is normally 35 yards deep. He's standing at the first down marker. There's the snap. Dutchtown goes at it. Ball hits at the 35-yard line, and it rolls to the, correction, ball hit about the 30-yard line, rolls to the 15.
Flowers punch down inside the
15. That's 1.5 first downs every time the ball hits the ground. 15 yards.
For 20 years, Klein Tuner Veterinary Hospital.
8:16 left to go in the third quarter. We have an outstanding District 5-5A contest between the Panthers and the Griffins. Week 6 of the high school football season. Santa is blowing out McKinley.
756-0204 to schedule an appointment.
Dutchtown will have East Ascension, East Ascension's homecoming next week at Griffin Field. Pyron flanked by Sampson in the backfield. Trip split left. Counter Trey. Good job by the
on the carry.
Defensive front, number 99, Devin Boyd, first one to make contact. Dutchtown pulling Quibido and Will DeLone running behind Mike Jones, the left guard, and right tackle Ethan Fields. Gain of about 1, 2nd and 9. Same formation. Number 7 playing on turnip seed. Sampson has it. Makes first guy miss. Second guy miss. Finally.
Sampson on the carry. Met in the backfield by
wrapped up about Panthers. 4 Panthers. Got to corral him. Getting off the ground. Number 26. Mason Watson. Inside linebacker, senior.
Third down and long.
Third and 10. Dutchtown hasn't put it in the air much. Last time was the last play of the first half when Pyron was trying to go for an open receiver and was hit on the play. Ball fluttered. Sampson in motion. Pyron tucks it, runs, dragged down by that same guy again, Mason Watson.
Number 26. Fourth down for the Griffins.
Be 4th and 10 for Dutchtown. Defensive line for Woodlawn doing an outstanding job. Clogging it up that number 54, Ellis McKinley, McNeely, Devin Jones, and Mark Fielder. Allowing the linebacker, Ketrick Owens, Jaden Woods, Mason Watson, and Deshaun Flowers to run. There's the snap, Pyron with the rugby kick. Deep, number 2. Deep, Adams for the Panthers, lets it roll. Great field position.
Kick is down around the 46-yard line where the Panthers will take over. First
for Woodlawn. Ball rests about the 46-yard line.
Local All-State agent Glenn Cox is a proud Woodlawn High supporter. Visit Glenn's office at 15928 Tigerton Road for all of your insurance needs. You're in good hands with Glenn.
Jalen Henry, one of the go-to wide receivers for the Panthers. Let's see if Coach Marcus Randle dials him up here or he keeps it on the ground. Counter Trey, good job. Amani Givens gets to the outside. There's a flag.
Amani Givens on the carry.
Good job of stuffing the counter Trey holding. That'll make it first and 20. Brought down by Tana Vadney. Shout out to EATEL. It is the EATEL game of the week. Hurricane Ida, I had EATEL every day. Never lost a second of service.
Moves the ball back to the 34-yard line.
No power, but still had ETEL service due to the Generac generator. Twins. Brody Anderson back at the nose. Good job by Dutchtown to sniff that one out. Collins wanted to throw a quick throw out to the right.
Brings up second down for the Panthers.
Dixon Agoo or Gabe Maribel on the tackle. Second and 20 for the Panthers. And just about 20 yards. They're going to mark it a little bit short.
Ball spotted at the 45-yard line.
But that was Jalen Henry on the reception. We'll make it third and one, brought down by Evan Reddix on the coverage. Panthers try to go quick. They're going to run that little trap right up the middle with Givens. And he bounces it, and he gets enough. Hard running by Armani Givens.
Uh-oh. Takes the ball down to the
usually in the
line.
Area of that's a face mask or a holding
first
flag on the play. See what he calls. See what the white hat has to say. Dead ball, face mask.
Face mask against the Griffins is the call.
Five-yard version.
Moves the ball down to the 35-yard line. First and 10.
Ball rest about the 35-yard line. 4:32 and left in the third quarter. 20-14, Panthers lead the Griffins. Collins in the gun. Really having an outstanding game. Flanked by Givens. Jalen Henry in the slot right here. He runs that same post route. And he is tackled by Tana Vadney, right on the money. Ricky Collins
down to about the 13-yard
to Henry.
Line. First down, Woodlawn.
First down about the 13-yard line. Second time that Ricky gets a little ahead of himself. It takes his eyes off the snap ball, hits the ground. He's got to tuck it and run. Saw something he liked. Evan Reddix on the stop. Loss of about three on the play. Look for number nine. Dutchtown committing a lot of folks to stop the run. 19. Ball was hit.
Collins pass. Ball's incomplete. Brings up third down for the Panthers.
Trying to figure out whether Dutchtown's playing man free or not. Third and 13. Trip split. Look for number nine. Number two receiver in the trips. Ricky's like to go to him. Amani out of the backfield, slant by number 19, and a nice, really, really nice throw by Ricky Collins on a slant. That'll make it fourth down.
Ball spotted at the 5-yard line.
Fourth and about two.
Fourth down to the Panthers.
And they catch Dutchtown in a hurry.
Flag on the play.
And going to get an easy first down.
Offside.
On offside. It'll be first and goal from about the 2.5-yard line.
Got to move the ball half the distance.
First drive of the game, it was Amani Givens around the left end. Oh, they're going to have to measure. I was giving them the first down. Oh, they call it a first down.
First and goal, Panthers.
They like to run behind number 58, Jerron Lewis, right here. In that tight bunch set. This has been their trap push up the middle. Oh, Ricky Collins takes it off right end. Touchdown.
Touchdown, Panthers.
Run behind Tillon Day off the right side to put the Panthers up 26-14. Plenty of time left to go in the game, though. 229 left to go in the third quarter.
Tate in to attempt the extra point for the Panthers.
Told you from the onset that this would be a good high school football game. It has not disappointed.
Kicking up and good, and with 2:29 remaining in the
27-14.
This score is Woodlawn.
And we'll be back after these messages with the EATEL Game of the Week.
From jambalaya, pastelaya, and gumbo to daily lunch specials, Pot and Paddle Jambalaya Kitchen has Cajun dishes to satisfy your hunger. Pot and Paddle has three locations to serve you, including the one on Cabela's Parkway in Gonzales, Jefferson Highway near Bluebonnet in Baton Rouge, and Jubin Crossing in Denham Springs. You can dine in, carry out, or let them do the catering for an office get-together or tailgating at the big game. And don't forget about their delicious daily lunch specials. You can check out their specials and more on the web at potandpaddle.com.
Woodlawn to kick off after their fourth touchdown. This one's Ricky Collins. They're sharing the wealth. Four different people, four different scores. Sky kick. The number eight. He's still running. He's around the edge. Number eight for the Griffins is Tyler Adams, a sophomore wide receiver. Gives Dutchtown great field position at that 39-yard line. Griffins need an answer. Panther band feeling it right now. Pyron flanked by Sampson in the backfield. Penetration by the Woodlawn defensive line.
By number 97, Mark Fielder.
Disrupted the flow of that play. Second and 11 for Dutchtown. Baylor Langwa in motion, put it in the belly of Dylan Sampson. He's on the outside. Nice block, nice hurdle. Got hit. I'm telling you. He gets 7 yards right there. Can't see much better 7-yard runs than you saw right there. Broke three or four tackles. Third and about four and a half. Tackled by a host of Panthers. Dylan again. First down.
Champion on the carry. Takes the ball to midfield.
Make Dutchtown to
first and 10.
Dutchtown. Chris Cooper on the tackle. Jaden Brown checks in for the Griffins. He and Bella Langwa in the backfield with Pearson Pyron. Ball sitting at midfield. Jaden Brown, Baylor Langwa on the carry. It's about one.
Langwa on the carry.
Brought down by Ellis
Cooper,
McNeely, senior defensive lineman. And that'll be the end. And all we do is flip it around. And we'll be back on the EATEL Game of the Week.
From jambalaya, pastelaya, and gumbo to daily lunch specials, Pot and Paddle Jambalaya Kitchen has Cajun dishes to satisfy your hunger. Pot and Paddle has three locations to serve you, including the one on Cabela's Parkway in Gonzales, Jefferson Highway near Bluebonnet in Baton Rouge, and Jubin Crossing in Denham Springs. You can dine in, carry out, or let them do the catering for an office get-together or tailgating at the big game. And don't forget about their delicious daily lunch specials. You can check out their specials and more on the web at potandpaddle.com.
Number for the TV is...
Start of the fourth quarter. Both teams four. Dutchtown's got to win this fourth quarter by 1 point. If they're going to come back 27-14, Panthers lead the Dutchtown Griffins.
And now for the half and half. The
Griffins now go from right to left.
8-8-5-1-1-2.
Quibido pulls. Pyron follows him. Second down, picked up about eight. Be third and about a yard and a half.
Come to the press box to claim your
prize. Dylan back in the backfield. Back in the game.
Brent on the carry.
Brought down by Owens.
Panther 42-yard line.
Call it third and two.
Third down and two.
Dutchtown's had some success with Icky's at that sniffer back. They hand it to Dylan. He bounces off of one.
Sampson on the carry.
Picks up three. Enough for a third down. Brought down by
the 40-yard line, first
number four,
Dutchtown.
Chris Cooper and Mark Felder. First and 10, ball rests about the 38-yard line. Dylan outside zone. 12 does a great job of stretching it out.
By number 12.
But no gain. Number 12 does a great job. Kendrick Owens. Clock runs. Under 10 seconds on the play clock. Brown with his first carry of the night, number 32. Brought down by Cooper. Jaden Brown, senior running back. Be third and seven for the Griffins. Thank you. Griffin's put the ball in the air about as much as Army football right now. We'll see if Pyron puts it in the air here as Woodlawn calls timeout.
Woodlawn.
Gives Dutchtown a chance to think about it. When you're down by 13, you start looking at that clock. Do we have enough time? We need two possessions. Dutchtown probably only going to have two more possessions after this one. And if they do get a third possession, it's going to be with limited time, like 2 minutes.
The winning number is 885.
Left to go in the contest. Need a score here to bring this within a one-score game.
Come to the press box to claim your prize.
Evangel. Was the Dutchtown's first game, week two, 38-7. Covington, 37-15. Averson Sci Academy, 42-0 at homecoming. And last week to go 4-0 at Ouachita, 42-33. That 4-0 record in danger with the Panthers leading 27-14. 9:43 left to go in this contest. A great high school football game. Dylan Sampson back in the game. And Pearson gives it to him around right end. And the call hold and yellow flag on the play.
They're in the flag on the play.
That'll back it up.
Against the Griffins.
Make it third and about 17. Dylan gets run out of bounds.
Penalty, we'll be 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Moves it back to the 45-yard line. Brings up third down and 16.
Third 16, clock stop. Tyler Adams, wide. Leif Watkins, number two. Position in the trips. Caleb Ickes in the third position. Pyron back deep. Looked like he was hit.
Pass falls incomplete.
Falls incomplete.
Fourth down from Griffin.
Intended for Leif Watkins. Be fourth and 16. Number two,
Adams,
Clayton Adams. Deep on the punt, deep on the kickoff. Tyrone gets his punt off, goes out, hits, goes out of bounds. Referee looks like he's going to mark it about the 15-yard line. Griffins need a three and out. 9 minutes left to go in the ball game. Need the defense to step up. Woodlawn has a large offensive line, and they have used it to their advantage. Collins goes under center for the first time tonight. Henry deep, toss sweep out of that bunch. 22. Carter Hanbury strings it out. First time Woodlawn has run that play tonight. A little toss sweep out of bunch. A.K. Burrell also on the stop. Woodlawn pulling big. Kylan Day. Little quick hitch. Just what the doctor ordered. Intended for number 15.
Intended for Gildersleeve.
Gildersleeve. Cade Mackey for Dutchtown on the coverage. Clock stop, 8:08. Third and about 13. Dutchtown needing to stop. give his offense a chance. They need two scores. The clock was running. The clock shouldn't have been running on an incomplete pass. Clock shows 7:50. At a minimum, it should be 8:08. Referee is going to talk about it. Good job by the Dutchtown coaching staff to catch that. Referee must have a microphone to the referee in the press box. His microphone must not be working. I think they said 8:22. Coach Randall trying to use his microphone to talk to the coaches, to talk to the... It'll be 8:22 is on the clock. Clayton Adams needs a new headgear. Number 80, kind enough to give him... his helmet. They're really good friends if they shared a mouthpiece, but Ricky Collins barking out signal, 3rd and 13. And he lets it fly. Almost a tremendous catch by Henry. Through his hands, which would have been a first down. Coverage by
Collins pass intended for Henry falls incomplete.
Brings caught a Hanbury along with A.K. Burrell being over there. Big stop, clock stop. Only took 5 seconds off the clock on that play. 8:17 left to go.
Burrell back deep for the Griffins. Flowers.
A.K. Burrell.
For the Panthers.
About the 39-yard line deep, waiting for the punt. Short punt goes out of, look like it's going to die about the 30-yard line.
Punt is down at the 30-yard line.
Short field for the Griffins. Can they take advantage? 8:07 left to go in the contest. Dutchtown needs a quick score.
All right, fans, we have a new number for the half and half. A new number for last two tickets. 885-197. 885-197.
Wayne McKinney at left tackle for the Griffins. Dylan Sampson got a crease.
Sampson on the carry for the Griffins.
Trying to see who was on that stop. Maybe number 10, number 90, 92 CJ May. Second and about 8. Baylor Langwa, nice run. See if the referee will give him a first down. Clock, he's waving his hands, first down. 7:25, tackled by number 10, Jaden Woods. Griffin's trying to go hurry up. Ball at the 20-yard line in the red zone, the EATEL red zone. Again, Baylor Langwa behind the pull of Ty Quibido. And Mike Jones and Ethan Fields. Short gain.
Second down and 9.
Will DeLone back in the ball game. Second and a long eight, short nine. Pyron flanked by Sampson. Nice crease.
Sampson on the carry.
Down to about the 12-yard line. Bring up third and two for the Griffins.
Takes the ball down to the 12-yard
Clock ticking,
line.
6:30 and counting. C.J. May on the tackle again. Definitely four-down territory. But we need to move it. We need to move the chains. Stop the clock. Pyro on the keeper. Gets hit head on. Made it to about the 10.5-yard line. Fourth down. This is the ball game right here. Devin Boyd, number 99, junior defensive lineman. First one.
Fourth down for Griffins.
To Pyron. They give it to Sampson. Sampson's short. He's short.
Sampson on the carry.
Number four, I think Chris Cooper.
Turnover on down.
As Dutchtown turns it over on downs. .537. Decision time, when to use timeouts for Dutchtown. I'm sure Marcus Randall has some confidence to put the ball in Ricky Collins' hands. But I expect Armani Gibbons to get three carries. Great job by A.K. Burrell.
Armani Gibbons.
After a short gain, Hanbury forced the ball to bounce. Clock stop. 5:26. Brody Anderson checks out. Aiden Lewis checks back in.
Timeout, Dutchtown. The Panther Sports Medicine Program would like to thank Baton Rouge Orthopedics for their continued partnership.
27-14.
Orthopedic teams with our athletic trainer.
Panthers lead.
To provide the best care possible for our student athletes.
Score two in the first. To go up 13-7. The top 10 in Class 5A. Everybody undefeated in the top five. Acadiana with at least a loss to Catholic High, 3-2 at number six. Captain Shreve came to Ascension Parish and ended their season last year against East Ascension. Ruston at number eight. John Curtis at 1-1 at number nine. Destrahan at number 10. Ricky Collins on the keeper. Great job forcing the football on the outside. And a tackle by Tana Badney and Anson McCaffrey. Second down and about seven.
Timeout.
5:20. Get another stop here. Get another short punt by Woodlawn. Could put the Griffins back in business. With a short field. They're going to need a quick score. And an onside kick. Third and seven. Good high school football game. Week six, District 5-5A. Next week, Dutchtown is East Ascension homecoming foe at Dutchtown Empty backfield. You got to believe Collins is keeping it.
Timeout, Woodlawn.
Woodlawn calls timeout. Third and seven, you want to run clock.
Fans, let's hear it for our Woodlawn fans.
Nobody else in the backfield. Ricky Collins gets the football.
Also for our Woodlawn cheerleader.
Ricky Collins committed to the Purdue Boilermakers this morning. Spent a lot of time running behind Jerron Lewis tonight. Senior left tackle, number 58. See if he does that here. Clock running, 25-second clock, 9 seconds left. They snap it. They're going to put it in the air. And there, Jalen Henry. Unbelievable throw by Ricky Collins. Threading the needle. Hanbury right there. On a throw. Just missed it. When you're playing not to, you're playing to win and not to lose. He puts the ball in the hands of his senior quarterback. Now Woodlawn's going to try to use clock. He'll probably snap it with 5 seconds left to go on the play clock. Hand it to Amani Givens.
Amani Givens on the carry. Gain of a yard. Timeout, Dutchtown.
Dutchtown uses their third and final timeout. Dixon Agu on the stop.
South Point Volkswagen is proud to serve
437
the
left to go in the
Mandeville Volkswagen communities.
Contest.
South Point VW has been family owned and operated since 1992, and they're the largest VW dealership in Louisiana. Check out their new and pre-owned vehicles, including the award-winning family SUV VW Atlas, the stylish and roomy VW Tiguan, and the popular VW Jet. Learn more at southpointvw.com. And remember, if it's on the lot, it's online. South Point Volkswagen on Airline Highway in Baton Rouge.
Second down in about nine, a long, short 10, long nine. Givens tries to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Givens
doesn't.
Carry.
Agu, Vadney,
no gain on the play, brings up third down for the Panthers.
On the stop. Third down and nine. Woodlawn and no rush. Seconds on the play clock. That'll put it about 3:48 on the snap. Last time on third down, Woodlawn put it in the air. Ricky Collins keeps it this time. And depending on where the spot is at, it's right at the sticks.
Collins on the carry. First down, Woodlawn.
And they call it a first down. 3:40. Ball rests at the 45-yard line of Woodlawn. Dixon Agu called his name quite a bit tonight. Henry. Right in the middle in that little trap.
Davion Haynes.
Agu again.
Moves the ball to the 47-yard line.
As well as Evan Reddick.
Second down.
On the stop. Second down and about nine. 3 minutes. Just went under 3 minutes. Panthers lead 27-14. No rush in this opening contest of District 5-5A. Just being patient. No rush. 8-7 on the play clock. Just inside zone. Same play. Henry, that scored. On a 45-yard run early in the first quarter. A.K. Burrell on the stop and caught a Hanbury. Dutchtown will be the visitor next week. Don't know how they're going to do that, whether Dutchtown will be on the home side or they're actually going to flip sides next week as they play East Ascension. Hadn't heard. Henry again, right in the middle, breaking tackles. Another first down. 148.
Deion Haynes on the carry.
Dutchtown can't stop it.
First down, Woodlawn.
Well-conditioned football team. Caught a Hanbury both sides. Don't see any cramping. It's really humid tonight. Both teams exerted a lot of energy. .130. 15 seconds left to go on the play clock. There's a snap. They hand it to Armani. Alvin Lewis. Nice open field tackle right there. Series will go 7-3.
Second down, 13 for the Panthers.
Be two in a row for Marcus Randall against the Griffins. Victory formation. The snap, the kneel.
Collins takes the knee.
30 seconds, and they won't have to snap it again. The Panthers win 27-14 against the Dutchtown Griffins, and that is your EATEL Game of the Week.
And that's the ball game. Your final score.
We'll see you next week.
27, Dutchtown, 14.